ladies and gentlemen, Warren Beatty and Annette Bening.
Tomorrow, our newly elected leaders stand before the world and take the oath of office. And without a sword being drawn or a shot fired, the nation moves forward.
This peaceful transition is one of the most remarkable features of our democracy, and it's followed by something called the honeymoon. Ah, the honeymoon. That period of time between taking the oath of office and the first serious clash of ideas.
Tomorrow is the beginning of a well-deserved honeymoon. Governor Clinton and Senator Gore, those of us in the entertainment profession who believe in the necessity of your election wish you a long and productive one. May it stand as a testament to this nation's desire for constructive change.
And may it last until your re-election in 1996 so that we don't have to wait. We don't want to have to wait another 16 years for one of these shows. You know, to do just one of these inaugural galas every 24 years really hasn't been enough rehearsal for me to get it right. So over that period of time, I have been introducing a number of activists at various fundraisers. And one group includes a singer, a composer, a writer, a producer, and a director, and I think I can save us some time here if I just introduce them all at once. Ladies and gentlemen, Barbra Streisand.
The then governor of Arkansas at a fundraiser in California last September. He told me what his favorite song was of mine, and I said, well, I'm not singing it tonight, but I'll tell you what, I'll sing it at your inauguration. I am so happy to say here we are. This is a promise I'm delighted to keep. This is for you and Mrs. Clinton. The April snow. ageless and ever. Thank you so much.